Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, we're very lucky this evening to have with us Madam Jackie Stathopoulos Kallas and her husband, Dr. Andreas Stathopoulos.
Very pleased to meet you.
But I'm afraid we have to blame London traffic. I'm sorry I haven't greeted you all yet myself this evening.
Can I, but I can't.
I'll take
no,
it.
Where can I have somebody to take Jackie's coat for me, please? Thank you. Yes, I will have it.
I fell, and all my body was in my hand.
It was falling, but luckily I didn't break it. And here I fell.
Never mind, it doesn't show.
It doesn't show.
No, you're very, very welcome, Jackie, with all this. So please do come and sit down.
Yes.
If you'd like to sit over here. Please sit here, Jackie. Andreas, helps me with advice financially and that sort of thing. And last, but far from least, Carl, wherever he is, here he is.
Here he is.
With our excellent magazine. And certainly all of the members themselves. We're all very, very grateful to all of you for being members. And I'm sure we're going to have a lovely evening this evening. So please, I would ask you now, it's not going to be much time for informal drinks, so perhaps we would get to the waiters in a few moments and start ordering your dinner if you would like to. And I'll get the waiters for Madam Kallas and Dr. Andreas. Thank you. Right, ladies and gentlemen, I don't need to introduce you again to Madam Kallas. We have all met her this evening, although unfortunately not all of you yet have had an opportunity to speak to her personally. But I think at the end of this evening, she's very kindly going to try and sign some of her books here. Now, I know some of you have brought your own copies. Jackie will sign them for you. If you haven't, perhaps you would like to buy one that the publishers have brought here. Also, a rather lovely photograph that I was able to take of Jackie in Athens last year. They are also available by arrangement with Nigel, if you will speak to him. Well, in the last 3 weeks of the Maria Kallas International Club, in which club we now have, I can tell you, 215 members, which I think and hope you will agree is a very, very good number, as we have only been existent for some 12 or 13 months. Quite a lot of you here tonight, and I'm very pleased, but we have to realise that there will always be members within our club who unfortunately I think will never be able to come to any of our events, least of all unfortunately one of the nature of this evening. I'm thinking particularly of course those really overseas, Australia, China and Eastern Europe. And I would like to ask all of the members here today, you've all got our magazines. Madam Kallas has also agreed, very kindly. Some of you know, maybe all of you know, we all know about Maria Kallas, but Madam Kallas, Madam Jackie Kallas herself was a singer. I won't give you all of her story.
She's a singer, a pupil.
A pupil.
A little correction.
Right, Jackie. However, she could sing. And we do have here a recording that was made in 1957.
I had made a concert then.
And in Athens, a public concert. And
after 2 years study.
Only 2 years study Jackie had had. We have to take that into account. And unfortunately, her studies were interrupted. She was, of course, a pianist as well. Who knows, we may have had, as with the Canetzi sisters, Maria and Jackie Kallas, but with her own private and personal life, it just wasn't to be, however. So now, Madam Kallas, with your permission, I'd like to ask you the first question, please. This is glasses time, ladies and gentlemen. One of our members asks you, please, Madam Kallas, how do you feel about being the sister of Maria Kallas? And don't you, and haven't you sometimes felt that you want to cry out and say, well, I'm a person too, in my own right?
No, I have had that feeling. I feel very proud that my sister is one of the biggest singers in this world. And she's not only a singer, as I was saying before, she was an actress also. And it makes me happy and proud that she was my sister.
That's very nice answer.
Yeah.
Adam Callis, thank you. That's one question.
Second question is, how did you feel when you appeared in Parnassus Hall during your 1957 concert? Did you at that time want to give that concert, or was your mother primarily responsible for organizing it?
No, my mother discovered Maria's voice when she was a small girl, because Maria, as a small girl, could not understand if she had a voice or not. Isn't it true? My mother discovered her voice. My mother helped her and the conservatory in everything. I cannot say, but the truth is that. Also, my mother discovered my voice after many, many years ago, because one day I usually play piano, and one day I sang, I don't know why I sang, a certain song, just a Chopin that I was playing. And my mother was coming by the stairs because the elevator had broken, and when she came up, she says, did you have a record of Maria now where you can? Oh, my mother, no, are you kidding? I said. She said, why are you singing? You have a voice. I said, no, don't kid me, mother. She says, really? I never thought you had. Why didn't you never opened your mouth? And she says, I said, mother, you will start lessons, she said to me. I said, mother, I'm not, as Maria had begun her lessons. I have a certain age. I cannot start now. What can I do now? She says, don't do anything, just for yourself. So she persuaded me and I started. And in 2 years I gave this concert, which you will hear afterwards, and you'll tell me your opinion. Okay?
Small question. Do you still play the piano and
yes,
sing?
Yes, yes, yes. And I sing for myself. I still have a voice.
That's great.
Yes. That depends on the health of the person, you know.
Yes.
You know what? I will tell you one detail, which I didn't know. We never lose our voices, we lose our health. Maria did not lose her voice, she lost her health, the diaphragm. Because all the voices, this is the power of the singer. She lost her health.
Yes. Can you describe, I'm asked in some detail, Maria's character and personality as a young teenager?
When she was young, she was a very, very dynamic person, a very clever, a good musician. Very good musician, very great talent. You could see it from a young age. The only thing that my sister had at that time, she was very fat. You see, she had a lovely face. Of course, her face was beautiful, beautiful eyes, all was beautiful. Her face, she was tall, very tall. But her body was very, 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 very fat she was. And this, I believe, as I judge, I don't know if I am not right, I believe that all this made a complex in her at the early age, you see.
Yes.
Of course, I was not a beauty, but I was more slim.
Yes.
And perhaps, you know, and her mother was very beautiful. She was young.
Yes.
And very beautiful and slim also. And perhaps she compared herself with her
yes.
mother and her sister.
Yes.
And she couldn't get over this thing. I see that when she became thin afterwards, she was lovely. It was like a model. Beautiful afterwards. But that was what she had the complex from a small girl, which made her not to love me, because she loved me always. We had nothing to separate. I helped them during the occupation. I was engaged, as I told with Mr. Enricos. And we had, the father could send us money, and he took the family all the economical side. And he helped Maria, my mother, and myself very much. He's dead from cancer, he died. So I believe that I helped my sister. I cannot say she hated me, but it was a certain jealousy.
Jealousy.
Which, she became famous, and when I saw her afterwards in 1963, she was the same as she was a small girl.
Yes.
Certain things that she said.
Yes.
I said to myself, you have become famous. You are beautiful now. I said to myself, I couldn't say it to her. Why? She had this complex. Because I was nothing. Compared to her, I was very unfortunate. I had ill my fiancé then. I was not famous. I was nothing. And still, it was in her. For certain questions that she said. You see, I believe that's the case. And we had nothing else to separate.
No.
Nothing. And I see that she had some conscience, we would say, because before she died, about a year and a half, she sent me a present. So I thought it was that she was helping my mother, because she sent something to my mother, so a small amount of $200. And she sent to me one Christmas, she sent me $200. I thought it was for Maria. I said, Maria, I said, what is this? For my mother, I mean. And I said, you have made a mistake. I said, oh no, Jackie, I just wanted to give you a small present. For 1.5 years, she sent me $200. And I can say that maybe it was her conscience, because she never invited me to her house. Mm-hmm. She never, as a sister, to invite me to say nothing. All these years, ignored. Perhaps in her soul, she thought that she wanted to revenge this way. I don't understand. I can understand it. No, I can understand it. you know, we were one day, we were invited in 1963 when I spoke to her again. My father wanted us to be good sisters. And because, you see, in 1951 it was, I asked her to help my mother because she had divorced my father. And Maria refused. As I said, Maria, I have helped you always, and during the occupation I was near you and everything. I think now, I don't ask for myself, I have no need. Mother, you can help her. I don't want to annoy my fiancé always with my mother's affairs. And she refused, and I didn't speak to her for 9 years afterwards. She became famous in between and everything. And my father, when he came here, he was a pharmacist, he came here in Greece. He says, no, Maria was all nasty with Onassis then, and my fiancé was dying at that moment. And we made up again. You see, and Mr. Garofalidis was a doctor, was the brother-in-law of Onassis, and he invited us for his house in Glyfada, you know. So he said, while we were eating, oh, you know, that's why I tell you she never changed in that. Well, Jackie, he says, I heard that you had a voice also, but why did you do nothing with your voice? I said, wanted to speak, to explain to him. He says, who has a voice? Just like that. You mean I? Well, we know you have a voice. You are the great Maria, he says. Callous, we know you. I mean, for your sister. Oh, but she says, the donkey's dark, bark, and you think you have a voice. He says, what are you going to do at your age? And it was in 1963. Well, I was not old in 1963, for God's sake. Oh, I fell out. You understand? So I can see that she didn't change. I said, Maria, I said, the painter can have a voice, and he can have a voice. What they can do with this voice? I had not the opportunity to do. You know how unhappy I am now, and I have left it. You have a voice. Your mother is crazy. That's why I tell you, that's why I say that she had the complex in her. She couldn't stand it that I could do something as a singer, you see. I think that's the case. I don't know. But I cannot say that she didn't love me inside her. Because I helped her, I did nothing, I never annoyed her in her life. So she felt it, maybe subconscious in the end, you see.
Well, she couldn't step over her shadow.
No. She couldn't get over this thing. Although she became famous.
Next question.
Yes.
What became of the Maria Callas Foundation after all the troubles with Fazıl Tefeci? As far as we know, Agnes Balsa is the only singer of repute up to now who received a grant from that foundation for her study.
When Maria died, we had separated this fortune of Maria's with Mr. Meneghini, because he had an old will. Maria had left an old will from 1954 to her husband. So he agreed with my mother half and half. So Madame de Vergy was a very close friend of Maria's, you know. And she said that Maria wished a foundation to be in her name. So I agreed, yes, since it was Maria's. And we gave her $800,000 for this foundation, which I never saw it. It just disappeared. I don't know what she did with the money. When I asked her, she says, we only have 50,000. Well, 1,800,000, what happened? You understand? When you want to steal, and the house of Maria's disappeared.
The shares.
She took the shares. She knew everything about Maria, you see.
Can I remind you that the Medici in front of the Greek courts asserted that I never received even one drachma in foreign currency from the family of Maria in front of the court.
And not only that, I helped her by economically.
She took $800,000.
She had arthritis.
Put it in her pocket.
She had arthritis, her hands were like that. Yeah. And I pitied her because she gave us certain papers to help us in this case. And I gave her a lot of money. I don't want to say the amount. And she said that she never received even one penny.
Because she brought an action against Jackie.
Afterwards, yes.
In order to that she exercises the moral of Maria instead of Jackie.
Yes.
But this claim was dismissed in front of
the court.
And the court says that the of the same blood sister is the only person in the world. Yes. Exercise this right.
Anyway, I'm sorry for her. I think her end was not very
was
good
not
either.
Very good, has there been another foundation? I mean,
there's
no foundation.
No foundation. The money disappeared, and I saw no foundation. Nothing.
Would you agree that, unfortunately, Maria was not a good judge of character? And so made some mistakes in her circle of friends.
I don't know about that because I think she had good friends. I think that there are many people who loved her and she had good friends. But for Madame de Vergy, maybe she didn't judge her. Madame de Vergy did not show her real character. Sometimes you don't show your real character. You see them afterwards, you see. For Maria?
Excuse me. This is the point that de Vergy couldn't take advantages of Maria when Maria was alive,
because Maria
knew the character of de Vergy. Jackie ignored the character of de Vergy.
How could I know who she was under them? And don't forget that Maria did not give easily money to people, you know, she was a little stingy.
Yes.
Maria
used the friend of de Vergy, Mr. War, as a driver, as a taxi driver to...
Onassi had given her a beautiful car, you know, Mercedes, as a present. She never used it. She used to go with Mr. Roy, is a friend of Madame de Vergy, who knew her many years, to the parlor, beauty parlor, always with the car of Mr. Roy, never with the car, or to go to an excursion, never, not to use benzene. I don't say against her at this moment because it is something that is in a person that they cannot help it, you see. It's not that I say my sister is not good at that. There are many people that are very good people, but they're stingy. I'm not stingy. I help many people. I say why? When I had my sister's fortune, I helped many families.
Yes.
And I saw that only two said thank you. All the others are enemies. But I thought I did something good. I said, since I have money, why should I help the other person? And Maria didn't have this feeling. It was her character. You're born with your character.
Yes. I have to say at this point that Madame Callas and Dr. Stathopoulos have also helped our club, which we thank you. Extra question that's just occurred to me. I don't know the name, I'm sure everybody else will, but do you know, Madame Callas, who signed the declaration on Maria's death that she should be cremated? We hear it was by a certain French gentleman that nobody seems to know.
I heard it from Madame de Vergy. She insisted that Mr. Roy insisted that Maria wanted to be burned.
So this gentleman, excuse me, my ignorance, everyone, we do know who this particular gentleman was or is.
I don't know, but I think
does anyone
know? Look, Jean, I think to Mr. De Stefano, too, she said.
Yes, Mr. De Stefano told me.
Yes, she didn't want to go under the earth.
Maria told him that I would like to be burned.
Yes, she told him also. That means perhaps that she wishes.
Maybe it is a
shock. It's awful. It was awful for me. It was ill that day.
Well, we thought about
her
last week when we were there.
You know, my sister was at home. Jean. and to see her in a metal box.
Terrible.
I couldn't sleep.
Terrible. No.
I couldn't sleep at night. I was shivering. It was awful. It's not nice to be under the earth either.
No,
but to see my sister in a metal afterwards, it's so awful.
Do you yourself go to concerts or operatic performances today? Which do you prefer? And what are your own general impressions of female singers today? And where would you place Maria Callas objectively, if you can, illustrator, female singers in this century?
Well, there are many talented in this world, but not because Maria is my sister. She's unique. When I hear Maria, I cannot hear anyone else. That's why I don't say it only I hear it from everyone who loves really music and understands music. I cannot hear any other singer. There may be good singers others also, but for my opinion,
it's very special.
Something
unique.
Special.
Absolutely. Slightly lighter question, but you just mentioned my height and Maria's. Taking into account that Maria was rather bigger than I am when she was young, and that was then considered at least to be rather ungainly, is it perhaps not in hindsight, because all those years ago when Maria was a young teenager, and indeed when I was, it was fashionable, I think, in almost every country for a young woman to be bigger.
Yes, but not so much.
Maybe that is the point, but taking into account that she was so tall, everyone said to me today, you've lost weight. Not particularly complimentary necessarily. So I think with Maria being even a little taller than I, as apparently she was, but she was really too ungainly.
I believe that Maria ate too much, perhaps. Maybe something lacked in her, and she wanted to eat. When
in
she went to America to her father.
Yeah, in lack of love for her
yes,
mother,
perhaps. No, her mother, she adored her. Her
yes,
mother,
but
she was a...
For a simple reason, for a certain reason.
My mother was a very person like myself.
I don't know about
it, they
but I know it is a compensation. Yeah. It is a compensation when you have no love.
She loved her.
Very
often to eat. She loved her.
She loved her.
Admiration
of man.
Maria,
I'll tell this
you
something.
This is
the
missing
of
not
Maria
the love of the mother. No. Maria wanted. Maria, one day I heard this and I read it also.
Yes.
That Maria was born to have a family.
Yes.
Maria loved family. She wanted a husband and she from a small
children.
In Mexico, when my mother went to Mexico to hear her there, she said, Mother, I cannot make children. I'm so unhappy. If I could make a twins and to die the other day, I would be happy. You see, she wanted a husband from a small girl.
Yes.
And wanted a husband and children.
And children.
And perhaps at her age, when she was young and when I was young, many people asked me. Perhaps it was my luck. And they did ask, and one person didn't ask her. So perhaps this made her something that lacked in what she wished, you see, to have a husband, to have family, which I didn't wish that, because my father was good, my mother was good, they didn't agree. And I was brought up in a family that was not loved between them.
Yes.
And that made me hate marriage. I said,
yes,
if I'm
yes.
going to marry, and I'm going to be like my family, I don't want marriage. But it had another effect on my sister. I was like that, my sister wanted a family, you see. And perhaps all this, something lacked that she wished, you see. And she ate. They told us when she went to my father in 1945 in America, a person who had this ice cream parlor, he said, I will tell you something to my mother. You know, Maria, after her studies, with her books, she came and ate 11, 12 pastries before she had dinner. So it is natural that Maria was fat. Because when I saw her after when she had become thin, I said, Mary, where is that? Where did this fatness take place? It was all fatness. Her body, her skeleton was very thin. So she ate too much then. I love music, I cannot say, because she studied very hard. If I had discovered my voice then, I would have loved to make a career, even if I died young.
Yeah.
But since I did make a career, I'm more happy now that I'm alive and I'm healthy and I have my very good husband.
That's lovely. Are you still in touch? May we ask with Ferruccio and Bruna?
I don't know. I have a very long time to see them. The truth is that Bruna and Ferruccio were very devoted to my sister, and she loved them. But unfortunately, Maria did not, I cannot believe that she didn't want to leave something to be independent to their servants.
First of all.
Yeah, but she didn't think, I think, that she would die so young. And she delayed. She wanted, Madame de Bazille told me that she wished to make a will. To make them independent, because they had never a salary. She never paid them. You see, all the years, 25 years, she never gave them one salary. She gave them for their illnesses or their trips, but salary never. So these people were in the street when she died. So I can never believe that my sister would wish this thing. I would never believe this, because she loved them, and she would never be ungrateful to a person who is with her 25 years. But she didn't think that she would die so young.
No.
And she delayed every time, delayed. Many people are like that,
yes,
you see.
They don't
other
want
people
to
wish
think
to
about
make.
It.
They don't want to think. So we did not leave these persons like that.
No.
We gave $500,000 to each to be independent. And Nagini didn't wish this. But we said we don't agree.
Nagini objected.
No, we don't agree in anything if you don't do this. Because we couldn't leave these people in the street, for God's sake. I believe they love Maria.
Really? And I must say that Bruno was so grateful to you that the VG is bringing an action against Jackie in the Greek courts, proposed
for the moral,
a witness
right?
against Jackie Bruna. So the witness.
And yeah, the VG had a certain
but,
power
yes,
over them.
But Bruno accepted
a great
this.
Power over them.
Accepted this to be a witness against you.
People are ungrateful, and it's all right. I did my duty because it would not be nice for the people to say that my sister didn't give them money all the years. Not that she didn't wish.
In general terms, what do you think about the literature on Maria?
Pardon me? I didn't hear this.
In general terms, what do you think about the literature on Maria?
The people who have written about Maria, many people have written about her career. And which are very nice books, I think, the majority. The only book that I didn't like very much was Mrs. Sassinopoul, because she said many scandals, which they didn't. They were not nice about her sister.
And untruths, eh?
And
well.
Yes, of course, untruths. I didn't like certain things.
There is a new book coming out on did you know, this month?
No, I don't know. Who?
Yes,
who
Nigel. Where is Nigel? Nigel, can you give Madame Callis the details? What's his name? Michael Scott.
You and Maria could have had an operatic career like the Conezzi sisters.
If I had begun my singing lessons when Maria had begun singing lessons, instead of studying piano, perhaps, I don't know, I cannot say. That is only in the future. I mean, what would have happened if I could do? I had a beautiful voice, as they say, but I don't know what I would do.
Yes.
No one knows. If you don't try, isn't it so? How would I know? Perhaps I would be very good. I would be a good actress also. I don't know. I didn't have the opportunity to see myself this way. So I cannot have any opinion.
No chance to
prove it. No. When did you first become really aware of the fact that your sister Maria had an absolutely exceptional voice? When did you say to yourself, here we do have something different? How old was she?
For Maria. Mm-hmm. From a small girl. This I can say though, that her mother helped her. Because my mother loved music, and she had, we had a piano there. Everything that we played, my mother bought everything for us to hear. And we started the piano. Maria didn't follow so much the piano as I did. Maria started singing from a small girl.
She
my mother. And I accompanied her, yes, because I was more
or aggression. A little songs.
La Paloma.
La Paloma, La Bichard, something like that. And she was young then. She was 11 years old.
You realized then?
Yes, we realized that she had a voice. Of course, no one would think that Maria would become the famous Maria Callas.
So you didn't think that, really?
That showed in the, yes, why one cannot know anything. The future only shows that.
Do you remember the last circumstances when you and Maria were together still as friends and sisters? And do you have your own theories as to why she did not contact you for so many years? And then did so, however, but a few weeks before she died.
Yes, I told you I had not spoken to her for 9 years because she refused to help my mother. But afterwards, when my father came here, we spoke again. It was his wish. And from then I saw her one day only at the yacht she called Nato, with Onasino. Just we had tea together. And from then on I didn't see her. She went to Paris afterwards, and only we telephoned sometimes. That's all, only by telephone I didn't see her again. And only I heard though that in the end that she was not well. And she told me that her low blood pressure, she had 8.
Yeah,
and she said, what do you do, Maria? Why don't you call the doctor? I kept calling them. She used to call. You see, very low pressure. And, before she died, she spoke to me very much in 1 hour, as I told you. But I did see her from then. She never invited me. She didn't want to. I was very proud. She may be my sister, but I'm a very proud person. I will never say, I will come to visit you unless you invite me. Never. I would rather die. But it's her character. She didn't want to, I don't know. Because I think if we were more near her, maybe she would be better. I don't know. She was alone also. She was alone.
Yes.
Onasi had died.
Yes.
She was a lonely person. Yes.
That's why we asked earlier about her friends, really. As you say, she was alone, and at the end she was. Some people seem to have...
As Vasa told me, Devanti told me, that she didn't want to go anywhere. Only she saw, sat down, seen television. She took many pills to sleep.
Yeah.
I think that is what was the worst. She wanted to forget, perhaps. I don't know.
Taken already.
The Nina Foresti concert when Maria was young. There's quite some controversy about that, Jackie. I wonder if I could ask Richard to put the question to you rather better than I can, please. Would you mind, Richard?
Yes, I'd like to ask about her her career when she was singing as a child of 11 years, and you were playing the piano for her.
I was playing the piano. You know who she admired? Rosa Bonsell.
Ah, yes.
Oh. When you're a family, you know, when you're a family, we used to go there and hear these records of Rosa Bonsell, and Maria says, I'm going to be more famous than her. Imagine. She had a great a dynamic person she was, and they used to laugh. Imagine that. The small girl says that she will be better than Rosa Bonsell. Oh, she loved Rosa Bonsell. She used to hear. She used to take, and my mother used to take her to the library, you know, because we couldn't buy all the records to hear. And she used to hear by hours. Yes, she wanted it. She loved it.
When she gave the concert, giving her name, as we understand, as Nina Foresti, there seems to be some query as to whether that's in that particular interview. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Well, did you know that she was in a program called the Major Bowes Amateur Hour?
Yes, that is when she was 10 years old.
Yes. Well, do you know that they've discovered the recordings of those radio programs? I have it here.
Really?
Yes, and but it wasn't in her own.
Small children, you know.
Yeah.
Other made speeches, others piano they played, others sang. My sister sang "The Heart That's Free." I used to accompany her in that.
So did she sing with her own name, or did she give her another name, or what?
I think her own name.
Really? Because there is a letter which is signed Nina Foresti, and nobody knows whether this is her or whether it is somebody else. But if we play the record, maybe you can say whether Is this the tape recorder here?
No, not yet. Well, I'll ask the last question and then I'll
move. Because she also, she talks, well, this little girl on the programme, she says her father is a chemist and she sings a bit of Unwell D.
Now, A Heart That's Free. A certain song, A Heart That's Free. A certain waltz it was, you know, waltz.
Did she make many appearances on the radio?
No. Only that. No. She had just begun to sing.
Madam Cullis, the last official question, and then perhaps you'd be kind enough to answer one or two more whilst we find a cassette, and then we listen to yourself singing. From the last conversation that you had with Maria on the telephone, I believe, when you telephoned her in Paris or vice versa.
Yes, from Paris. She did tell
And this must be an objective answer, not just a polite one.
What?
Do you think in the mood that she was in at that time, that had anyone come forward, myself or anyone else, to have asked her, would she like a club or a society to be founded for her, as, let's face it, most of the living opera singers today already have, do you think she would have approved? Of course you're going to say yes to be polite. Don't be polite. Do you think she would have done? What would you have done? In the mood you felt she was in the last time you spoke, would it have helped her, meaning to have known, perhaps, that there were, well, just a few people here, but a few...
I cannot say what she would really wish. This is her own idea. I cannot say that. I cannot answer this question. I have a witness of Mr. Sutherland, the pianist, Robert Sutherland. He told me that he talked about this matter with Maria.
Yes.
And Maria said that she was indifferent to this idea, so she was indifferent. Club of music.
Maybe she would agree later. Who knows?
Sarah told me 2 years ago.
Before the society and the club.
Yes, before.
Why did you think about founding one?
Did you
think about founding one? I don't think so.
Is he a member?
Not anymore. No. He was about to sing, it all takes quite a lot of work. But Peter, did you want to hear a little bit of the Nina Foresti before Jack? Would you like to hear a moment of Nina Foresti, the recording of Maria, and then we all would like to listen intently to yours? I'm sorry it's only on this equipment.
No.
Here we are.
Well, my ambitions were very high. But since my father's laboratory has closed, I've taken a position.
That's a new one of your father was a chemist. So what are you doing now?
Oh, I'm driving the car department, the life department.
Is that a voice of a girl? Is it possible that 10 years old girl to sing this?
We don't know. Impossible.
How old girl was
this? 10 years. Ten. Ah. 10 years old girl to sing this. Why they do this?
A very good director.
Does it? Can a 10 year old girl sing this? Not on. My sister sang a small song, Heart That's Free, for 10 years old. She had just begun. That's a trick. It's not her voice, first of all.
You think
Maria's voice is?
No.
There's nothing similar to her voice. I
know me for 10 years old, and later, it was similar. Isn't that true?
Not true.
Not true. But who did this? Who did
this? This person is trying to imitate the Maria style of singing, but she fails.
One moment. A 10-year-old girl can never sing this. Can never sing this.
Marion Talley was singing at the age of 8. She sang Cataloga at the age of 8.
My colleague will agree with me that the courts of a 10-year-old girl cannot produce this sound, eh? Do you agree?
Is it impossible for a girl of 10 years old to sing all this songs? First of all, it's not her voice.
Well, it's not my
voice. Very
but there have been singers in America
that have had this important voice.
Yes, but how?
She was 8 9, she was singing at home always.
Maria is my sister and I know her life.
And it is important.
It's not my voice. You can see yourself.
It's dramatic.
That is the
dramatic some of the gentlemen standing here. This is
not strong.
Look, this is the
no, 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 no,
no,
no, no. To the recording of Madame Jackie herself, but please remember that it was taken right back in 1957.
And in the magnetophone, right. Which was in the end, and it was not a very good one too.
And this is not an excuse.
It was, 2 years student of singing.
It was an even worse piece of equipment than the equipment that I have, I'm afraid.
This is
well,
worse.
I mean, by the, some of the gentlemen standing here, this is not good.
Gene,
no.
They propose to put it in.
Yes. Yes, all right. So please do
not
take
not on the this material.
So please do take the recording into account.
Is this side A?
Yes. Yes, I think I have the right one. Please tell me if I have this. Volume. Yeah.
Is this yours? And it's not good?
What? It's good.
And not from the beginning. No, this is Nebbia. This is Nebbia.
I was going to
mention. And the other side is Maria. She sings Forza del Destino and certain things that I sing.
Yes,
so
yes.
It would be nice if you could have a copy. We could make a copy. If I knew I could bring from Greece. But you could make a copy of this.
Yes,
in the epitaph of Bolivia. Otherwise, Bolivia is here, yes.
Thank you.
with the tenor and the bass. Yeah.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
said I have Maria, who sings the same thing.
She sings with her heart.
Jackie.
Well, a pupil, I think it is very difficult for 2 years to sing these things. Are definitely worse.
Sure.
Very difficult.
Does anyone else have a question before we ask Jackie to see if you can use your right hand and sign one or
yes,
two? Does anyone have another question, please?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Sorry, I
should know. Oh, many hours. In these 2 years. Oh, many hours I used to study.
Exercise.
Because, you see, yes, exercise, and I knew how to play piano, and I accompanied myself in all these operas. I didn't have need of an accompanist. Yes, this helped me very much because I knew music.
And the breath control is wonderful.
Yes, yes. Well, you must have, of course. Didn't we say we lose our health? We don't lose the chords. We lose our health. I mean, when you lose a voice.
Who was the teacher?
Vikinos. He was the pupil of Zacharias, you know, of the...
Yes. Paula Zacharia.
Yeah, and Golfopoulos. He was a very good teacher, very good teacher.
Did you see the article in the Sunday Times this week?
No.
About Maria?
No. Was it good article?
It's the...
What?
It's 1,000 people that shape the history of the world.
That's what made her...
Last question then. What is your personal favorite of all Maria's recordings? What do you like the most?
I think Maria is perfect. I mean,
yes,
her voice is lovely in all the operas, but what I like most, and I think it is her voice, is Puritani, Sonnambule, Lucia, Traviata, Norma,
Macbeth.
I think this is what Maria is perfect. Of course she sings Tosca, she sings Forza del Destino, but she's not perfect as she is in these operas that I mentioned.
Perfection.
It's something beyond,
admiration. The ultimate, yes.
Because it's her natural voice. This is her voice. Maria's voice is not a very, very dramatic voice, you see. It is a lyric coloratura. That's why she's perfect.
Another Greek lady over there who's
yes.
Would you have a question
Greek lady
to ask?
No.
Είμαι από την
Τουρκία.
Αλλά είμαι
Ρωμαίη, Ελληνίδα.
And she was more lovely in the stage. Because when she was fat, it was not nice on the stage because Maria was fat and after her marriage with Menegi. About 2 years she was awful. She became fatter. Yeah, didn't you see pictures of her? Afterwards, in the 50, I think it was, 50, 51, she became thin. She was lovely in the stage after, because she was tall and she had appearance. She was born stage appearance.